All right, well, finally, Wisconsin is getting winter, and we are getting hit hard. We have a ice, rain, sleet, and hail. We've got snow. We got it all mixed in. It goes from snow to ice, rain, to hail, back to ice, rain, snow. My Model S doors are frozen shut. The hood's frozen shut. I did manage to get the trunk up a little bit. However, the weight of the snow on the trunk latch makes it heavy as heck, and it will not stay up on its own. So we are going to find out exactly how well preheating the Model S defrosts and thaws the car. In fact, it took a number of tries just to get the door handles to come out. So much for their winter testing. I actually had to pound on each door handle to get, dang, I can't even turn around, otherwise my camera's just going to get nailed right in the lens. So, this is, there's a powder of it on right now, but the ice rain will come and just freeze everything. I actually had to pound on the handles that's how heavy it is. Oh, shoot. That's how much weight is on that trunk hatch. I can tell the car overall is sitting a little lower. Let me turn on night mode and night vision. There we go. The car is sitting a little lower. Only rear driver's side window would roll down when the handle's pulled. But the doors are froze shut. So I'm going to go in the house, and we're going to watch through the window the car de-ice and de-snow itself, unless I can find a tripod and maybe put the camera in a plastic bag and go at it. So let's check it out. Okay, well, I got the camera is wrapped in plastic wrap, and I found a old UV screw-on lens filter for my camcorder. So, loading up the Remote S app. I'm going to crank the interior heat to 90, which is the maximum. I'm going to start that climate. And, shoot, I think I'm going to have to lower the camera. It's too windy out. Move the camera back, but lower it. The snowbank should hold it steady. And I'm gonna let her get up to temperature. Hopefully the camera stays running. And I'll be back. See how long it takes to... Oh, there goes the hat. Holy crap. I'm gonna have to move the camera somewhere else. It's tipping over. Nope, that's not gonna work. Let me grab my hat. Holy moly. Wow, that's one snow-filled hat now. Oh, crap. Oh, here we go. Back here. I'm not at home, otherwise I'd be protected somewhat by the house, my house, but it's coming straight off the street. There we go. We'll go from this side. Can you guys see me? All right, good. Heat's running. The front vents on the front, the active shutters tried opening, but those are... looks like they're frozen. So, move this behind the trailer a little more. Man, is it freaking cold out. So, we're going to let that go. I'm going to work. I think I can get that back driver's side door open. I'm going to try and get that open and reach forward. I want to turn on the rear window defroster. Start melting the ice and sleet off the trunk window. Right now it is 43 degrees inside the car, 30 degrees outside, which I don't think that's correct, but it's got to be colder than that. Man, it's much colder. Either way, it's at the perfect temperature for everything to freeze. So, let's have the camera going here. Come on, Saran wrap, stay on. Even the Saran wrap's starting to get brittle. So, let's... let's let this bugger go, see what we can defrost. I'm going to try and get that door open and get the rear window defroster. If I can get the door open, I'm not even going to worry about the remote, you know, preheating. I'm just going to, turning the preheater on is pretty much the same thing as just cranking the max temp on the dash. I'll just leave the rear door slightly, you know, slightly ajar, so that way the heat will stay on, and that way I also don't have to worry about the heat shutting off after its timer limit. And let's just see what this does. So, see if I can get that door open. Okay, I was able to get the back door. Looked like me playing with it before was just enough. Back door, driver's side slightly ajar. So I have the heat set at max, which is 90. But I got range mode on. Okay, I'm going to have to go shut off range mode. But then I'll turn on the pack heater. I don't want the pack heater. Range mode on should be fine. I don't want the pack heater. Don't need the pack heater. Especially when the road's this slippery. You don't want regen. It can make you lose traction, at least on single motor cars, because it's doing all that regen braking with the rear wheels. On the dual motor, it's distributed between all four wheels, so it works pretty much like a regular brake at that point. Got the rear defroster on, and I got the dash defroster on, and I have it set to recirculate the warm air around, so it heats up a little warms up a little quicker. So I'm going to go inside the house so I don't freeze to death, and I'll check out in the camera in about 10 minutes so you guys can watch. I have no idea how long it's been going for now. Let's look at the camera. Ooh, snow everywhere. Let's see. It's been 18 minutes, 30 seconds. On the driver's side, both front and rear passenger windows are de-iced and snowed. I don't know if you can see it or not. Lens looks like it's starting to fog up a little bit. The passenger side front is de-snowed, but the rear has a little bit on it, but considering this is more the direction everything's coming from, it's understandable. The edges of the windshield are now melted, and the trunk, let's check it out. Oh, here comes the plow. The trunk, while not de-snowed or de-iced, the trunk has started to have a little bit of an avalanche effect going on. So everything that's on the glass is starting to slide down. I bet if I attempted to open and close it again, the slamming of it should cause that to fall on the ground. So I'm gonna give that a try. Otherwise, up to this point, it's just been preheating alone. Yep, just as I thought, the defroster melted that layer against the glass and it was all slid down. It was all just kind of jiggling around. Opening, closing it, loosened it up a little more. The broom just kind of got hung up on what was frozen to the painted portion of the hatch. So a couple gentle pushes with the broom, that came right off. I'm still interested to see how long it's going to take for the windshield to fully de-ice. As you can see around the edges on this side, and quite a bit more so on the driver's side, got about 3 inches on each side that's thawed. See if I can get my driver's door open now. And yes, I can. Driver door opened with no issue whatsoever, and in fact, how the door handles are designed is when you have your ventilation system on the car on, it channels a little bit of the interior air into the door panels where the handles are to help melt ice and slush that might be around those door handles as well if they get frozen, and. No problems now. It seems to be, well, the interior's been about 95 degrees according to the app, so it's a little warmer in there than what the heat set at, which is fine. We want that. One thing I just noticed is passenger front door handle light is out. Yet another failure to add to the list. But let's keep her going, see what else happens. So I'm gonna go inside. Now that the driver's door is working, I'm going to open that one a crack and close the rear one. And let's give it another 10 minutes. I mean, if I wanted to, I could just take the broom and probably brush off the windshield right now. But we're going from other than what was stuck on that trunk hatch, I'm gonna go for a total thaw on the windshield here. As long as my camera will hold out long enough. I don't think you guys can even see it anymore.
No, you guys cannot. Go figure. Let's see. Because the camera is focusing on the melted water on the UV lens than it is on the car. There we go. Let's try that a bit. Sorry, it's going to be the best we're going to get. You're going to have to take my commentary then. Because if I unscrew, this has got the Boss optical stabilization, so it's not a sealed-in lens like what would be on a standard camcorder. Moisture can get around that Boss optical lens. Think of it like an eyeball that moves around, and the whole lens and sensor in this camera are floating. So if I take that UV filter cap cover off, all this moisture and snow and everything can get right into my lens. Can't have that. Too expensive a camera, and I can't afford another. Hope you guys can see a little better now. It's getting even darker out, so let's turn on night vision again. There we go. Much better. Alright, I'll be back.
Well, time has come. Can't wait anymore. We gotta get going home. So I'm gonna take the broom to the windshield. While it is turning into a nice slush between the glass and the snow, it's gonna take a while for it to melt to the point where it all comes off. So I'm just gonna do a swipe with the broom. Just can't keep up. All right, that's it. Time for us to get out of here. And my saran wrap has officially blown off because it is not clinging with it being this cold. Good night, everybody. Smile, cheese.